AT&T and Verizon are scumbag companies, in my opinion. I have to say in my opinion because they got a scumbag company wouldn't think twice about using scumbag lawyers to give me their 2 cents on expressing my opinion. A few days ago, AT&T, Verizon had 200 plus companies and firms chose to no longer advertise on YouTube. And some people believe that it's because if you take away the power from YouTube and you play the racist card, the sexist card, the inappropriate material, inappropriate content for an audience, not enough safe spaces on YouTube kind of card, kind of shit. And you can take them to other companies that, or partner companies, take them out to go watch CNN, go watch HBO, go get on the Dish Network instead. Go back to your dumb box, your stupid box, which is television. And do whatever you can to take away the edge from your competitor. You know, me and myself, I know that there are a lot of great fucking great and also lame artists out there. Now, what the fuck, what would I have to benefit if I showed you someone else's work and says, oh, look at his work, or look at her work. It's shit, isn't it? So what if it is and so what if it isn't? You may like it, you may not like it. You may like it, you may not like it. But how would that make me look? What if I just say, alright, this is what I got to offer. Want to buy a print? Want to buy a shirt? Cool. Thank you. Stay strong, keep focused, make it happen, no excuses. I believe the channel is called 1791 or 1719L. And it also got other YouTube channels to make videos on all these advertisers leaving, giving you the scare that YouTube is inappropriate. But I think the great thing about the internet, especially YouTube, is that even though a lot of social justice warrior assholes, piece of shit motherfuckers are posting on here, I can post my rebuttal video. My video as to why that guy's a fucking moron, or why she's a fucking moron, or why they're wrong. But I think when we live within our means, don't take that big ass contract and buy a big ass home and then get that big ass contract canceled, so now you're chained to that big mansion you bought, to that big box item you got, that will leave you in a financial disaster. I don't have much more to say on that. One of the channels, some people are saying how this is all, this could also be related to the fake news flagging my fucking Facebook, where the mainstream media is losing its hold on us. And you guys are not able to live your life according to the fucking schedule that you want. You're no longer chained to coming home or getting to a television every certain day at a certain time to watch a certain show. You cannot just wait and binge watch. You can skip all the ads. You can buy organic, you can buy vegan, you can buy Made in America. Shit, you may even just want to watch, you know, my channel. You may just want to watch, maybe PewDiePie is enough for you. Maybe you don't want to be brainwashed into thinking that, you know, you need to become an American Idol, that American Idols are truly idols. That should be your ultimate identity. That those people are American royalty. And it is a balance to attempt to define your own identity, your own preferences in life, without becoming a walking billboard. I believe Hitler used fluoride in the water during World War II to help control his people. That's the theory. Fluoride is used a lot in toothpaste. I think our world leaders, our supposed world leaders, they're not the real bosses. They're not. Some motherfucker sitting on a big ass piggy bank at the biggest casino, world's biggest casino, which is Wall Street, who truly controls the, what's it called, the psyche? Mentality of the American, of the world. From a distance, do what I can to give you a refreshing point of view on drawings, on talking shit, on thought. Thumbs it up or thumbs it down. Go out for a walk. Stop and go out for a walk. Or continue watching. You know, go with your gut. What would our amazing leaders of the past, like George Washington, what I would consider great leaders of the past, George Washington, Napoleon Bonaparte, who else wasn't an asshole? How about Tupac? What would he say? What would he say with all this shit? Mind your own business and speak the fucking truth, because someone is listening. The internet doesn't forget.